Now, atropine sulfate is a parasympatholytic drug that increases sinus or atrial pacemakers and enhances atrioventricular conduction. In general, atropine accelerates the heart rate. A parasympatholytic agent is a substance or activity that reduces the activity of the parasympathetic nervous system. The parasympathetic nervous system is often conversationally described as the rest and digest portion of the autonomic nervous system. Atropine blocks this action. Now, let's look at indications. Atropine is used for the treatment of bradycardia. In the pediatric patient, atropine is recommended over epinephrine for bradycardia that is due to excessive vagal tone, cholinergic drug toxicity, or in other words, organophosphates, or a complete atrioventricular block. Atropine is also the first choice treatment of symptomatic AV block due to primary bradycardia. If a child with symptomatic AV block does not respond to atropine, the child may require pacing. Now let's look at some of the precautions and contraindications. Tachycardia may follow administration of atropine, but atropine-induced tachycardia is generally well tolerated in the pediatric patient. Atropine is not recommended and has no therapeutic benefit for pulseless rhythms such as asystole, pulseless electrical activity, VTAC, or VFib. So now let's look at the pediatric dosage. Atropine, whether it's IV or IO delivered, is going to be delivered at 0.02 milligrams per kilogram. It may be repeated once in 5 minutes. The minimum dose is 0.1 milligram and maximum single dose is 0.5 milligrams. Atropine can also be given down an endotracheal tube if there's no IV or IO access. The ET tube dose is 0.04 to 0.06 milligrams per kilogram.